And in the past, the committee has been kind enough to come to the location and stand in Martin Close, I think. I don't know if I got you round to Martin Close, actually. If you do stand in Martin Close, you see the impact that a house like this will have on the properties just on that bend. It's not an argument against the house being built here. It is a continuation of a discussion as to whether this is the most appropriate building. When the outline permission was given, the report that was brought to committee stated the proposed dwelling on the rear garden will not appear as an incongruous feature, as it will also be in line with other properties in Martin Close. Ish. Would we be able to put up the actual plan, please?
Which plan?
For the property.
Floor plan of the elevations.
Yeah, the floor plan. It's all on the dock, isn't it? The subject of this application sits situated much closer to 39 Martin Close than the other properties in the road. I just had to go a quick gather around with Google Earth then, because all the properties that I can see in that end of Martin Close have got a garage and a passageway quite often as well between them. They are well spaced. At the top of that plan, where you can see the elevation, and then underneath you can see the plan, you can see an indication which I take to be the outline of 39 Martin Close.
This here is 39 Martin Close, yes.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. So this will be visible as you come along Martin Close. HS4 requires that the proposal is the scale which relates well to the surrounding property, in particular with regard to density for development. Well, I'd suggest that this property is not quite the same as Martin Close. The style is different with the dormer windows and so on, which also look towards THURSTASTON Road. And the report actually mentions that it keeps overlooking to a minimum of 36 THURSTASTON Road, so therefore acknowledging that there is some overlooking. So the total floor space of the new property is at least 50% larger than the ones that you would see in Martin Close. And the length of the wall next to 39 is 13.7 metres compared to 9.25 metres to the Martin Close one. Nearly half as much again. So these lead the residents in Martin Close to feel that this is a large property which is overbearing and out of context with the others in the area. And the area in general doesn't have a high density of homes. It's not in keeping with the area to have such a very large house squeezed into a small plot. And I guess that's the crux of the matter. It's about opinion. It is not considered that this dwelling is of a scale that's suitable, says the report. Well, by some people it's not considered to be of a scale that is suitable, and that's a difficulty. So members, I'd ask you to just think carefully about that. If you believe that this is not of a suitable density and contrary to HS4, then you could perhaps refuse it. Importantly, if you are minded to move approval, could you please just look at condition 4, which is there? I believe this is relating partly to relatively ground level. Can I suggest that there is a word which must be inserted? It's the word not. Because currently it says that you must create, if you're going to do it, this, that or the other, it must be done without reference to the local authority. And the local planning authority used the not word in there. No, not whichever. Thank you. I knew you'd know. It had just disappeared from the the relevant piece. So thank you very much for your time.
Thank you,
Mandy.
Can I open this up to the committee? I'd just like Matthew to explain some of the comments made by Wendy, if that's okay.
Through you, Chair, if I can just go back to some of the
comments that the council and comments have raised. Yeah, we're not saying that there isn't going to be overlooking of the garden, the rear garden at 36 Martin Close, 36 Thurstason Road. What we're saying is that the level of overlooking is to an acceptable degree. And I would point out that the rear elevation of number 39 Martin Close, and also this property here, they also currently overlook the garden of 36 Thurstason Road. And the first floor elevation, the first floor rear elevation of the proposed property doesn't sit any further forward than 39 or that property. So in terms of what overlooking, there is already overlooking of that garden space. In terms of the separation distances, it is true that there is only 2 metres between the two properties. There's a metre from the boundary fence to the side gable of the proposed property. And that is the distance that we would normally expect to be achieved so that people can get wheelie bins down or get access down the back of the property. I have walked around Martin Close, and there are a number of properties in Martin Close that are either within 2 metres of the boundary or the adjacent property or closer. And just to point those out to you, that's this group of properties here. There's a group of properties over here. This relationship here, they're also close. So in terms of the closeness between that property, we do feel that 2 metre separation distance is better than what we proposed previously and is acceptable.
Chair, we shouldn't compare applications with applications, but this site has a planning history, and Wendy's quite rightly been very vigilant over this site and has objected and took it out of dedication. My view is fairly similar to what an application has like that they move in every way, shape or form they can to get the design and the location of the building to pass the planning test. The officers have approved that it has passed the planning test, so my view is that in the balance of things that it should be approved.
Again, I have to concur with what Steve has said. I think they've gone out of their way to try and meet the requirements of the planning officers in every way they can. And as a result of that, whilst I totally understand the concerns of residents and of the Wendy tenants that are council for that area, I don't think they've got a sustainable reason for refusing this that would have any chance of resisting.
This application seeks consent for the erection of 2 self-contained, one-bedroomed, assisted living units within the grounds of Arrowe Hall. It follows an application approved last year for 2 units immediately south of this current application. So just on this plan, these are the 2 units that were approved in July last year, and these are the 2 units that are now proposed. All 4 units sit immediately adjacent to Arrowe Hall, and the residence garden, ensuring the proposals do not impact on the setting of the greenbelt. The units will allow for individuals with specific care needs to live on a short-term basis, learning to live independently whilst benefiting from a safe environment and the wider facilities available at Arrowe Hall, before relocating more permanently to assisted living sites within the community. The The location of the units are discreet, ensuring they neither impact on green belt or the setting of the grade 2 listed building. The proposals are recommended for approval. There's no petition in relation to this application.
I move approval, Chair.
I'll second that.
Members are asked to consider the matters from the delegated powers between the 11th of January and the 7th of February. I just have one comment to make in respect of this on page 101, which is the last item.